Hi, everybody. This is Beth Cooper. I'm Zooming with three fabulous artists in New Mexico, and I'm the owner of Bluebird Studios in Santa Fe, New Mexico. And I have with me today Michael Chesley Johnson, who is recording this for us, and Roberta Remy, who is down in Las Cruces, soon to maybe be moving, right, Roberta, to Albuquerque?
No, I'm going to be here. I'd like to actually come back to Santa Fe.
Yeah, well, we'd love to have you. So, and we have Albert Handel. Albert, give everybody a wave.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
So thank you all so much. I am just pinching myself because I have these three plein air pastel oil painters that are so well known around the country, and they are willing to, Michael and Roberta are willing to come to Santa Fe and do a workshop for me. And Albert is a dear friend of mine, and he has been for 15 years maybe. And
wow, time goes by.
I know. Took my first plein air workshop from Albert down in Tucson, and he was so sweet to me because I produced some really bad paintings. But anyway,
you have come a long way, my friend.
Thank you.
Come a long, long way.
Thank you. I appreciate that. So just a quick synopsis. I started Bluebird Studios last year. Wanted to start it before that, but you know, we had a little incident in the world called a pandemic. So we started up and running. Last year, I had six workshops with 54 students, and it was so much fun. Everybody had a blast. We just plein air painted. We worked in the studio, and it was so much fun. And this year, I'm offering 12 workshops. And I just wanted to have Albert, he agreed. He was so generous to help me market these wonderful artists. And he is also really good friends with Michael and Roberta. So I want to have Albert maybe step in here and tell his relationship a little bit with Michael and Roberta.
Okay, I'm stepping in. First of all, Beth, I'm so happy that you started this program. And all these lovely people will be coming to Santa Fe. And I will open my studio for all your teachers and students. They can come during the workshop in the afternoon, or the day before in the afternoon, or the day after. So I have an open studio for your people. Roberta and I go back a long time. We were studying at the Art Students League on Saturdays, and we were under 20. wouldn't you say so, Roberta?
Yeah, we were kids.
And Michael, we met, I don't know, I'm losing track of the years, but me and Michael have done workshops together. He has assisted me. Back to Roberta. She does lovely works, and they're figures and portraits and still lives. And Michael Chesley Johnson, he basically does a lot of landscapes. I know him as a landscape artist, and he knows his business. He's written a book and written many articles, and we've spent a lot of time together. I've spent time together with both my friends. That's why I'm on this thing. Amen.
Hey, thank you, Albert. So I was going to let Michael and Roberta tell us a little bit about their workshops that they're doing. So let's see, Michael, yours is first before Roberta's. So do you want to just give a little who you are, you know, what you do at your workshop, what the students can expect, kind of a thing?
Sure, be happy to. My name is Michael Chesley Johnson, and the workshop I'll be teaching will be plein air, and it's 4 full days. And the way the workshop runs is we start off in the morning with a talk about some fundamentals, and then we go on location where I do a demonstration. And after the demonstration, students get to paint And I go from easel to easel offering help. And then time permitting, we'll either do another demonstration in the afternoon or head back to the studio to talk more about what we do. And some of the things I cover will be, choosing a location, picking a subject, looking at thumbnail sketches and values and designs, color usage as it relates to plein air painting, and then dealing with plein air pitfalls, such as changing light conditions and so on. So that's kind of what the workshop's going to be like. And I'm excited to teach it. It's going to be a fabulous 4 days in Santa Fe.
Great. Hey, Michael, can you tell everybody about your book?
Oh, my book. Yes, it's called Beautiful Landscape Painting Outdoors, Mastering Plein Air. And it features over a dozen other artists who share their tips and techniques. And it's full of demonstrations and lots of good color images. And it's available on Amazon and also Barnes & Noble. And I'm told it's available at Michael's and Joanne's.
I bought my copy of it and I really like it. So thank you, Michael. I'm really looking forward to having you here. And since I'm a plein air painter, a lot of my classes, my workshops are plein air. And there's limitless places to paint around Santa Fe. In plein air, we can paint here at our little horse ranch, which is about 7 miles from the plaza, or I know hundreds, literally, of places to paint in plein air. So it's going to be really, really fun. So Roberta, you want to tell us about you and your background and your workshop?
Okay, well, I love painting people. And so mine is called Painting the Living Portrait. And every day we'll have a different model. And I'm going to start off each morning with a lecture on a different part of the features of the face. Because once you understand the anatomy of the features and the skull and the eyes, the nose and mouth, then when you look at the model, you understand much better what you're looking at. And it's easier to get a likeness and it's easier to paint those elements. So every morning I'll be giving a lecture, and what I'm going to do, I think, is I'm going to, at the end of the week, I'm going to have a completed portrait. So when I teach about the skull, I'm going to paint the skull that day, in that morning. Then next day, when the lecture is going to be on the eyes, and I will talk about, after I explain and draw the eye and teach the anatomy of it, then I'll end up showing how you do that in paint. And the same thing will happen with the nose and the mouth. And each day as I paint those things, by the end of the week, it'll be a completed portrait.
Wow. And,
yeah, and I do know a lot about anatomy, but what I'm going to do is try not to use all those words, because people start to hear all the anatomical terms and they do glaze over. But if I explain how it's functions and how it's built, and how, you know, and the measurements and the proportions, people are much more likely to get a successful likeness in a painting.
That's great. And, you know, I have an artist, a platform for the models to sit on with a lot, you know, really good lighting, light stands. So I'm really excited about this because Roberta contacted me. We had not met in person, but I feel like over the last few months, we really connected. And some of my really good friends have studied with Roberta and given her glowing remarks. So that's really exciting. So I just wanted to tell everybody a little bit about my concept for the workshops, and that I'm calling my workshop, it's kind of an elevated workshop, because I offer continental breakfasts. I bring in lunch. It's optional, but it's like $15. And I do a catered enchilada casserole. If we're painting plein air, we have box lunches brought to the site. We are located on a small horse ranch about 7 miles south of the plaza. I put my glasses on so I can see. And we have four horses. I have the studio itself is 2,000 square feet. It's big, it's open, and during the spring and summer and fall, we can open the doors, lots of good ventilation. I provide continental breakfasts. And then we have an icebreaker the night before each workshop starts with chips and salsa and soft drinks. You're free to bring your own wine. I don't have a liquor license, so I can't serve wine, but it is happy hour while we're recording this. So cheers. So, and then I bring lunch out to the site. If we're painting in plein air or we have catered lunches in the studio, we go out for lunch one day. We go out for a group dinner, and we have an optional cultural excursion for people that want to do that. Somebody's from the East Coast or Canada and they want to experience a little more Santa Fe. We have a docent tour of the museum we can do. We can do historic tours of Santa Fe. We can go down to Canyon Road. A good friend of mine owns a gallery down there and he does a gallery talk for us. And then Albert Handel has graciously agreed to open his studio. And so we can go over there and see the studio of a true master. And I'm sure, Albert, we might be able to wrangle up some wine.
And, yes. Do so.
And so it's just, I call my workshops there elevated. It's not like, I remember past workshops I've gone to, like in the morning, I'm driving to the workshop and I have to stop at, you know, 7-Eleven and pick up a burrito. I mean, that's not my model. So I just want everybody to be really comfortable. And the other thing I wanted to talk about, I know we're on a little time limit here, is with COVID and the proliferation of Zoom workshops. I took some and I did enjoy them, but I did learn from them. But however, I don't have the memory like I do maybe going to Albert's workshops where we went up to the mountains and we painted and we had a picnic and then we went out to a nice dinner and the camaraderie and all the people I met and the friends I made. So I wanted to have each of you tell me why we need to get back to live workshops and not always count on Zoom. So Albert, you want to start?
Oh yeah, there's no comparison to in-person relationship. And for my own workshops and for your artists, they come to my studio. It's all there. It's an experience all by itself. And whatever I need, if I'm doing pastel and I want to feather something, which means push things back, I have an old pastel sitting there, which I can demonstrate that for. Same with oils. And I don't know how you can explain it, but I've made such great friends from giving workshops. And I like to teach. And I give some workshops still around the country. And a vacation to me means vacate the studio. And that's healthy, not just for the money, which is nice, but I'll come back and I'm fresh. And yeah, then I can make decisions for my painting.
Yeah.
For me personally, there's nothing like in-person workshop and relationship.
I agree. Michael, you want to give a little, your reasons for live versus Zoom? Did you do Zoom during COVID?
Yeah, I did for 2 years. Basically, the in-person workshops were basically canceled for me. I just couldn't do them. So I started doing Zoom workshops and also doing Zoom critiques, which has been a lot of fun. As attractive as it sounds to be in your home, and you know you're not wearing any pants and you're snacking or whatever, and no one can see what you're up to. I think in-person workshops are a lot. The wine too. I think the in-person workshops have a lot more to offer. For one thing, you get a chance to get more immediate and personal feedback as you work at your easel. You can't really do that online. You also get a chance to look at your instructor's demos up close. A lot of times the cameras aren't quite working well enough so you can see exactly what's going on, but with workshops, you can get right up close to see what's going on. You can also look at the work of other students to see how they're working and get some information there. And it's also a chance to network and make connections and to build a camaraderie that's just not possible online. And finally, you can get information during breaks and before and after the workshop that you probably won't get while you're online. And the ultimate thing is there are no technological hassles.
Yeah. Yeah. Isn't that true? I mean, I don't know if you guys just heard my dogs barking, but we have four dogs and they were barking a minute ago. So, Roberta, you want to give a little, Roberta and I Zoomed this morning and she gave me some really good insight of why she thinks that live workshops are so valuable.
Yeah. I feel that a teacher doesn't really get the opportunity to know the student and see where they're going wrong or to see what they need help with. So for example, for me, brushwork is very important. And I'll notice sometimes a student is painting like that. That's not painting, that's writing. So I'll be correcting them and telling them that they have to hold their brush at the end. I'll also be showing them how much paint to pick up on their brush, how to lay it down. When I look at somebody's palette, I know how organized or chaotic they are, and I could see what kind of other help that they need with that. When I'm watching people mix paint, I can tell if they're overmixing and that you shouldn't be overmixing and beat the paint to death. And so there's all these things that a teacher needs to see the student doing in order to be able to help that individual student. And also, I like what Michael said about that the student, you know, you learn a lot from other students. And when you see other students working, it's very illuminating. When you're alone in the Zoom and you're just listening to that teacher, all you have available to you is their technique, what they do and how they do it. You need the teacher to know you and the teacher to help you. So I feel pretty strongly about that.
Yeah. Yeah, I do too. That's great. And one thing we all have in common, except I feel like Albert's our common denominator too, is one thing we all have in common is we all moved to New Mexico. I mean, yeah. I was born in Durango, Colorado, raised in Oklahoma City, raised my children in Denver, but Santa Fe called me here. I mean, I learned to ski here at the basin when I was 10. So it's, you know, it has a great meaning for our family, but I moved here because of my art. And I took workshops here with Albert and some other artists because it was in Santa Fe. So can everybody just give a brief talk? Maybe Albert, you can start about why you moved to Santa Fe or New Mexico for your art.
Sure. I'm a realistic painter. And being in the New York City area is like being in the wrong place. And living in Woodstock, New York was terrible weather. And I heard that it's a good market out here. So I made sure I had a workshop in southern New Mexico. And I drove up to Santa Fe. And that was it. That was it. The market here for realism is wonderful. The weather is wonderful and the visuals are beautiful. You have second largest or third largest art market in the country leaning towards realism. And the beauty of the colors of the adobe and the winter skies and the summer greens, and the weather is terrific. And the visuals are wonderful. Many a time, I always take the visual route home if I go to the post office or wherever. And I marvel at the beauty. It's so beautiful and it's unique. You feel like you're not in America. That doesn't sound too nice to say, but it's true. I feel like I'm in Mexico or Europe. And for some reason, the light here is beautifully unique. I don't know why. Maybe it's the mountains to the right, to the east of us, as the sun goes down to the west and the sunlight comes through, and it feels like the earth is standing up. And mm-hmm. There's a lot of blue with that adobe color, which if I was an interior decorator, I couldn't do better. And they have that so they can keep the evil spirits out. But let me tell you, visually, visually, it's a pleasure. So between the galleries and the art market, the second or third largest market in the country, and the beautiful visuals, the light, like I say, you have to see it. And it's easygoing.
Yes.
So there's not a long ride to go from here to there. It's easygoing. And the food is unique. And if you find our chili's a little bit too hot, any dairy will cut it. Yeah. And so I don't know.
It's special. It's a special place, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, when I drive from our house down into Santa Fe, it's, I feel like I'm getting a big adobe hug.
You are. And you deserve a big adobe hug. What you're doing with your program is wonderful. I am very thankful for it.
Thank you.
And so is Santa Fe. And so is everybody who comes here to participate as a teacher and a student.
Oh, you are so sweet.
God bless you, my friend.
Michael, you want to tell us a little bit about why you came to New Mexico?
Well, I could repeat everything that Albert said. I totally agree with everything. I'm also a big hiker, and I just love being outdoors. And for me, painting is about hiking, and hiking is about painting. So you put the two together, and it's a wonderful life. And it's just great. I love the light, love the open spaces, love the subject matter I get here, love the density of artists. I think we have more artists per square mile than anywhere except maybe, I don't know, New York City. But I just love it here. That's all I can say. And everything Albert said.
Yeah, great. Thank you. And Roberta, what about you?
Well, I pretty much agree with everything Albert said. And the other thing I like about it is that it's a small town, and it's very, it's easy to get around, and it's comfortable to get around. And it's, I'm a terrible driver, and I have a terrible sense of direction. So when I got here, it was just wonderful. And the light is just gorgeous. And it does feel like you're in a European country. There's just wonderful flavor. And of course, the architecture is gorgeous. Every day that I lived in Santa Fe, which was for 27 years, every day my eyes were so happy at everything I saw.
I love that. You know, I wake up every morning, my husband's here with me, and our dogs, we have four horses, but I wake up every morning, and we've lived in a lot of places because I was a Navy wife for 8 years.
Oh, wow.
And then we lived, you know, we moved around even after the Navy, but I wake up every morning and I say, I belong here. Yeah. I will never go anywhere else.
Yeah.
So. Well so anyway, said.
Well, thank you guys. I know we're kind of on a time limit. We wanted to keep this short, but I just cannot tell you how much I appreciate all of you. Albert, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You are such a treasure for Santa Fe, for the art world. I value all the paintings that I own of yours and the time we've spent together. And Michael and Roberta, we have not met in person, but I already know we're going to be really good friends, and you'll stay in my casita, and we will have dinners together and drink wine together, and we're going to have so much fun.